I just can't park my car.
I mean, you're free to recite it to me or give me the details. However, I am within my rights. I know my rights. Whether or not the city believes the First Amendment is in any way germane to, you know, real people, as they're proving today that they aren't. I don't really care what they have to say about the First Amendment because I've read the Constitution, I've taken classes on the Constitution, I know it cover to cover, and this is free speech. It's covered under the First Amendment, it's not criminal mischief, it's not vandalism, it isn't graffiti, it is chalk, it is water soluble, I'm not doing public damage, I've expressed it clearly political speech, and therefore I am exempt from any law restraining me from that speech. And I know that, so if you have to arrest me for expressing my constitutional rights,
that's not my intent.
Go ahead.
But like I said, I can't spew it word for word because I have to. But in life, I had to run out of the corner.
I mean, I'm busy protesting my government. I understand that perhaps moments exist, and I trust you in saying that you believe it does exist and that you believe it is your duty to enforce that law. However, I believe that this is not a constitutional ordinance, that the ordinance does exist, and therefore it is my duty as a citizen to ensure that my government does not infringe upon the rights of everyone else. And you guys actually, earlier this week, arrested several occupied Tampa protesters for very similar charges, but it was 20 or 30 of you, and you kept us on the ground and tried to humiliate us. And I'm surprised now that we're in public and it's not 5 o'clock in the morning that there's only two officers. The disproportionate enforcement of the law, also unconstitutional, is somewhat disturbing. And I don't think that I can, in good conscience, leave with you as I am at the moment, engaging in my civic responsibility to protest my government when they're infringing upon the rights of the citizen. So,
well,
do what you have to do. Do what you have to do, but I'm doing what three-year-olds everywhere do. And this is my right, and if you have to arrest me for it, I'll love suing the city.
Like someone mentioned, hopscotch and three-year-olds. That's all within that ordinance.
So political speech is included in that ordinance, which is one of the things embodied in our Constitution. If I draw a hopscotch square, and
But if you like, my car is parked right on the corner. I can't park my kids, flush out. It's an easy road. I had a parking spot to walk over. I can go over with you.
I am not going to your car.
No.
No. That's something that they told me not to do in stranger
neighborhoods.
I have the right to be anonymous before my government. I'm not committing crimes. So I'm going to keep doing this, and you do what you got to do. But when the government infringes upon your rights, it is your right to take down your government. That's what I'm trying to finish writing here. So I think that's a pretty good message to come out of this conversation. So I'm just going to keep on doing what I got to do, okay? All right, Jeff Devon. I know you guys can't handshake. So.
Oh, no, I haven't.
The only reason we have this First Amendment is...
Morning, Mikey.
Morning. Miss me?
God, it's good to see your smiling face.
You know, the First Amendment was put in place so that when the government started to act like they are, this First Amendment could prevail. This wouldn't be happening if... the government wasn't acting tyrannical right now.
Oh, the Declaration of Independence was put in that for that reason. Because the government was being tyrannical.
It's a manifesto. Well, that comes off easy. With spit. With spit. With spit. With spit. With spit. My own spit. He just took it off real easy like that. Show your hand.